Hi, how are you?
I'm Mikael Cozic. I'm an assistant professor at the University Paris-Est in France. And I'm very glad to be here at the Center for Philosophy of Science, University of Pittsburgh, for the spring term 2017. And my research, I have two main research areas. First, I'm interested in theories of rational beliefs and rational actions, that is, theories which try to answer questions like what it is to have a coherent belief, what it is to update one's beliefs rationally upon receiving new evidence, and what it is to act rationally on the basis of one's values and one's beliefs. And my second research area is the philosophy of economics, and more specifically I'm interested in the philosophical issues raised by microeconomics and decision theory. And my research project here at the center is related to this research area. Actually, it is related to a research program which was launched about 15 years ago and which is called neuroeconomics. Traditionally, microeconomics and decision theory try to explain and predict what people do in some choice situations, like for instance consumption choices in terms of their preferences and beliefs or expectations. And neuroeconomics is a research project which proposes to study this choice situation by relying on methods, tools, concepts from cognitive neuroscience, and notably by recording brain activity, for instance, through functional resonance, functional magnetic resonance imaging, fMRI. And since the beginning of this project, there has been passionate debates. All these debates revolve around the issue of knowing whether neuroeconomics is relevant for economics, given its aims. And this is precisely the big issue that I would like to tackle during my visit here in Pittsburgh. Some have argued that as a matter of principle, it's impossible for neuroeconomics to bring something relevant to economic science. And according to those people, economics is and should remain autonomous from what we can know about the brain of people working decision situations. I'm rather skeptical about these claims, but I think that the challenge they raise is very interesting because they force us to think about how this kind of project could lead us to improve the economic science, if at all, and they force us to think about that in more precise, rigorous, and constructive terms. So, during my stay, I intend to use reflections coming from philosophy of science, especially coming from confirmation theories and theories of explanation, to shed the light on some of the aspects of the relevance issue, and especially the issue of knowing whether evidence coming from neuroscientific studies can help to empirically appraise economic choice model, and secondly, the issue of knowing whether neuroeconomics can be explanatory relevant for economics, which means whether it can help to explain economic phenomena.